was recently researching unique geology when I came across an astonishing cave. I was captivated, so I packed my things and headed into the mountains to see it for myself. What I didn't realize at the time was just how puzzling the geology of this cave is, and how commonly misunderstood it is by most people that visit the site. I began the hike up the mountainside and was astounded when I rounded a corner and got my first look at the beautiful structure known as the Wind Cave. I was in awe of its majesty and was impressed by the massive rock formations that decorated the mountainside. But what were these rocks, and what does their composition tell us about the history of this terrain? Well, to understand that, we have to go back nearly 350 million years ago to when most of Utah was engulfed by a tropical sea. During the early Mississippian age, a gigantic limestone layer known as the Lodgepole Limestone formed below the seafloor in this area. And it was within this ancient limestone layer that the Wind Cave would eventually form.
I mean, these massive limestone chunks, it looks like kind of like a castle from here, just like perched up on the hill. I'm excited now, to say the least. So right now we're passing by some pretty impressive chunks that are surely a part of this same layer of limestone that comprises the Wind Cave over here. And it's just really impressive to see, you know, what was once a consistent layer underground is kind of just dispersed throughout this mountainside. This over here is really interesting. It almost looks like a chimney. You can see there's a few kind of openings or vents in the rocks. Be excited to see that. Not sure how well you can see this. Super cool. Has kind of a, almost like a little arch, but kind of some weathering goes through the center. Kind of a cool little piece there. Really beautiful. All right, so we have made it to the top of the cave. So the cave is just below us. So we're about to go down and check it out. But I'll tell you what, the views up here are just ridiculously good. And it's just cool to be able to gain this perspective. And it just kind of fills your imagination a little bit more with how this land developed. So you can see on the other side of the valley, you have this limestone layer that is essentially a part of this limestone layer that we're on top of right now. So, and you can see over here too, and way over here. So yeah, you can just kind of get an idea of how vast this limestone layer is and how it has been kind of broken up, but really impressive.
Now that I had gained a better understanding of the Logan Canyon landscape, it was time to head into the cave to see it up close. But there was still an important question remaining. Why did the Wind Cave become hollow, unlike all of the surrounding limestone? Many people assume that because of its name, Wind Cave, that it was eroded by the wind, but it turns out that that's not the case. In the midst of the tectonic events that took place here, there was a period of time when the Lodgepole limestone sat at shallow depths below the ground surface. At this time, the Lodgepole limestone was just below the water table, where it was able to interact with groundwater, which is capable of dissolving limestone. As rain falls, it absorbs carbon dioxide from the air, and as it seeps into the ground, it mixes with the carbon in the soil, creating carbonic acid. So the acidic rainwater slowly dissolved the limestone along joints and fractures. As time went on, the Logan River incised into the canyon walls, and eventually, the Wind Cave was exhumed.
Unbelievable. It's a huge cave, and it almost just feels like this doorway was meant for people to just walk right in, and you know, you have great shelter.
Something that stood out in my research on the Wind Cave was the potential to see fossils embedded in the limestone. so I eagerly started to search the cave for signs of ancient organisms.
So just around this corner, we have another section of the cave. There's some interesting shapes in this cave. You know, just random little details like this that make you wonder how it happened. Pretty cool. Unfortunately, you can see here, there's a spot that has been graffitied, and it's just so ugly. Yeah, you know, the one thing I'll say about that is, I think it's a shame that people came in here and graffitied this wall. I think it really kind of compromises the beauty of this place. It's still an amazing spot, you know what I mean? Like, but it's just kind of disrespectful and selfish. And, you know, it's like other people want to come here and see this and enjoy it. So I would just encourage everyone to avoid doing this kind of thing. This space isn't ours. The earth isn't even ours. Just don't do that. I just think it's a shame, you know? So I have yet to come across any fossils. Still kind of on the lookout for that kind of stuff. This is something that I'm sure a geologist could tell me in an instant that I'm just not so sure of, but I wonder what this white is on the limestone. Is it salt? Could be, you know, a sodium or salt deposit that's attached to it. That would be my assumption, but it's really pretty. The thing that I'm unsure about is amongst all of this limestone is like where to really spend my time looking for these fossils. Is it more likely on, you know, the walls in the caves, which I inspected pretty closely? Is it more likely to be amongst all this broken down rock? I'm starting to feel like maybe amongst this broken down rock. That's why I've kind of started to sift through some of these rocks, but you know, it's just kind of cool observing. Look around a little more, see if anything shows itself. This is interesting. This right here. This looks like some sort of shell. I think that's a fossil. And then you have a smaller fragment right there, but definitely looks like some sort of shell embedded into this stone. Pretty cool. Here's another little something I found petrified into this rock. Really have no clue what this is. Got an interesting shape, that's for sure. I thought maybe at first it was like a petrified bug, but I don't think so. Interesting. Well, found another large stone with some fossilized material. Something similar to that last one. It just makes me so curious what this is. And then like this right here, it's got a interesting pattern, whatever it is. You know, it's funny. I told myself that I was gonna just beeline it down the trail back to the car, but my curiosity is just so piqued. It's like all these rocks that I'm passing, I just wanna turn over all of them and see what's on the other side. I think it's safe to say that I kind of got the bug for this stuff now. You know, it's like, as much as I want to find something to show you all, I also just want that satisfaction myself and just, I'm just curious about it, so.
As I headed down the trail, I felt a sense of fulfillment having taken the time to try and understand the wind cave and the surrounding landscape on a deeper level. I gained a new level of respect for the natural wonders we often take for granted. But I simultaneously felt a void, still having so many questions and such a strong curiosity for some of the things I had found and seen. After my experience at the Wind Cave, I am now all the more eager to educate myself further on the geology of the Great American West.
Well, everyone, I'll tell you what, this has been a special adventure. Just another amazing place added to my list. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. If you have any feedback for me, please, I'd love to hear that. Leave a comment. Would love to learn more about, you know, the people who are watching my videos. And so shout something out, what you liked about the video or something that you might want to see in the future. You know, I'd love to hear all that. So thank you all very much for tuning in. It's Johnny Out West. Till next time. See y'all.